A good theory is falsifiable. Falsifiability explains why we use null hypothesis testing. Falsifiability means that a theory makes sufficiently precise predictions that, if it was wrong, we could measure it. This does not mean that the theory is false. It means that if the theory was false, we could know. Not all theories are falsifiable. Some theories cannot be demonstrated false, and those theories are not particularly useful. When we use theories for hypothesis testing, which hypothesis do we test? You would think that researchers would begin their research by searching for something that they wanted to demonstrate true. Something like, diet and exercise together result in greater weight loss than either one alone. And while it is true that we have such experimental hypotheses in mind, the hypothesis that we actually test is the hypothesis that says there is no difference. We always start with the assumption that neither drug works better than the other, or neither diet nor exercise nor a combination will cause weight loss. We start with these because these statements are falsifiable. We start with a hypothesis that we want to test to demonstrate that it's false. And this is called the method of contradiction. The method of contradiction offers up a statement that can be demonstrated to be false, and then we use our statistical techniques to attempt to do so. The fact is that statistics can never prove a hypothesis is true, but we can sometimes demonstrate that one is likely to be false. And that is because we work within the realm of probability. On the other hand, facts and reality can, in fact, prove that something is true or false, even if statistics cannot. So let's start with a statement that is not falsifiable. The claim is that there is life on other planets. Well, how could you prove that true? Pretty simple. Find life on another planet. Yes, it is true. But could you prove this statement false? We go to one planet, no life. We go to another planet, and another. Still, no life. We go to all the planets in our solar system. We even go to Pluto. No life. Then we go to other solar systems, other star systems, other galaxies far, far away. Still, no life on other planets. Despite all of that failure, someone can always claim that we just need to look at more planets. That statement can never be proven false. On the other hand, if we start with a statement that is falsifiable, our outlook is better. There is not life on other planets. Now, can that be proven false? Yes. Find life on another planet, and we know that that statement is false. Can it be proven true? Well, sort of. We can't prove that it is true, but failure to find life on other planets supports this claim. We can say that all available evidence shows that there is not life on other planets. And this is why scientists at NASA are not looking for life on other planets. They are looking for planets that have the greatest likelihood of supporting life, specifically life as we know it. Find other planets in the universe with the same conditions that gave rise to life on Earth, and you find the best places to begin looking. Until then, there is no life on other planets, as far as we know. The claim that there is life on other planets won't work at all, because it is not falsifiable. The claim that there is not life on other planets is not perfect, but it will work. It is falsifiable. It can be demonstrated false. All of our null hypotheses will follow this same model of using the word not or no difference.